this tutorial on some basic ArcGIS operations. For this particular demonstration, I am running a Windows 8 machine, and I am using version 10.2 of Esri's ArcGIS software suite. The very first thing I'm going to do is start ArcMap. And I'm going to say blank map right here. We'll be starting from the very beginning. What I'm going to do here is not only demonstrate what I call that magic of GIS, but I'm also going to try to demonstrate to you a few different things that you need to know inside the software package in order to get it up and running. It is a complex software package. It's got a lot of power to it, but there is a whole lot of options and a whole lot of functionality. And so a lot of people aren't used to that when they come and take my GIS class. And so this is also the first sort of thing that I tell them in order to begin using this software package. I want to draw your attention to two different components of this software right now. I'd like for you to look over here on the left where it says Table of Contents, and this is where it's going to list all of the data that you've loaded into the program. If you look just over here beside the Table of Contents, to the right, you're going to see the Display area, and this is where it's going to display all of the information that you've added to your project. So some people open up ArcMap for the very first time and then think, well, gee, what am I supposed to do? What is it supposed to do? Well, in order to do anything with ArcMap, you're going to have to add data. And actually, the separation of the project and the data is an extremely important concept for people who are just getting started out in GIS to realize. But in order to add data to this project, I'm going to go up here and I'm going to click this button. And when I click that, I get this window here that says Add Data, where I can navigate to a particular data set that I would like to add to the display. You will notice that if you drop down here, you have a selection of different folders to choose from, but it happens to be the case that the folder that I would like to add data from is not available here. And this is very common to occur, especially if you're working with thumb drives in a laboratory environment. You may have to do what they call connecting to a folder. So let me show you how to do that. I need to connect to my folder. I'm going to go over here to this button that says Connect to Folder. It is a great idea to connect to the uppermost folder that contains all of the data you would like to use. I'm actually going to import some world GIS data, and I have a folder about that right here, but it's in a folder called base GIS data, so I'm going to go ahead and connect to that folder. That way I can access any of these folders that do have my GIS data in them anytime that I want, and I don't have to connect to this folder and then go through this process again to connect to this folder later on and then connect to this one when I want to use it. I'm just going to connect to this top level folder and say OK. Now you will notice in this drop-down list, it does have that folder that I'd like to get to. And when I click there, I can see all of the different folders that I have inside. I'm just going to add some data about the countries of the world. And so inside my World GIS Data folder, you will see a lot of data here. You'll see all these green shapes with these different emblems inside, and then all of these names out here. This is GIS data. This data is held in something called Shapefile Format, and it's a very standard GIS data format. If you take even an introductory GIS course, you're going to learn a lot more about the shapefile format and be using a lot of shapefiles in order to accomplish GIS tasks. So as you can see, I do have a fair number of shapefiles in here. Let me tell you that the data that I have in here is a little bit outdated. If you just installed the ArcGIS software package, ArcGIS does come with a couple of different data DVDs, so if you're wondering where you're going to get your initial data to sort of get started and see what's going on in ArcGIS, well, please make sure that you have those two data DVDs so that you do have some data to work with. If you download ArcGIS, then you may need to be sure that you also download these data DVDs. Lots of people don't know that they're there and they don't have any data to at least get started with, so please be aware that if you are downloading ArcGIS, to make sure that you also download the data DVDs so that you have something to work with. I'm going to add country 04, which is just a shapefile of all the countries of the world. So I'm going to click on the shapefile here, and then I'm going to click Add. And there we go. That's what I get when I add this data into ArcMap. You can tell this data is outdated just from the geometry, just because it doesn't have South Sudan in it. If you're following along or you have your own country data, yours may look different. Every time you add a shapefile into ArcMap, it comes in a random color. So you may have pink or green or some other color. If you want to change that, you can change that up. That's easy to do, and if you're doing a nice maps, then you obviously want to do that. But whenever you pull in a shapefile, you're just going to get a random color. So now you'll notice over here in the table of contents under layers, the shapefile that I added is now listed, that country 04 shapefile over there in the corner. You can see that it's blue, and of course over here in the display area, as you've obviously noticed, has appeared in the display area. So this is the first characteristic of GIS data. You've got all this geometry, you've got this line work here in the display area that's showing you some geographic aspect of the data set that you've added. So I have the geographic representation of all of the countries of the world here in my display view. But there's more to it than just that. I also want to show you that not only do I have the geometry here, I also have tabular data about all of these countries. I'm going to go over here to the country layer, and I'm going to right-click on it. When I right-click on it, I get a bunch of different options that I can do with that data layer. The one that I'm interested in right now is called Open Attribute Table. I'm going to go down to Open Attribute Table, and I'm going to click it. When I do that, I get this table, which looks a lot like a spreadsheet to those of you who have used spreadsheets in Excel or other software programs. And this data table gives me a whole bunch of different information about the countries. I've got the country's name, I've got its long form name, I've got its sovereign, I've got population, probably an outdated population column, as I was saying, currency type, currency code, and its square kilometers and square miles. So this is just some data that I've got here about all the different countries. First of all, I'd like to call your attention to this toolbar up here. It's got a whole bunch of very useful tools you will use all the time. Zoom in and zoom out with the magnifying lens. That's very important to go and inspect a certain area and zoom out in a certain area. And the hand tool allows you to pan around your project. Also, if you are zoomed in and you're trying to get back out to everything, back to the entire view, if I go to the globe here, it goes to what they call full extent. That would get me back to viewing everything in my project. Fixed zoom in and fixed zoom out, that's rather self-explanatory. That helps move you in and out of the project in a certain step pattern rather than sort of a freeform pattern that can be done with the magnifying lenses. The Go Back to Previous Extent button is very useful. If I were here, but I wanted to get back to exactly where I was before, I can just hit Back. This is pretty useful if you are zooming in and zooming out to different things. I can just go back. Oh, now I'm back to where I was. The Select Features, you use that button to select geometry, and then you use this button to clear anything that you have selected. This cursor, Select Elements, will help you, well, resize, move any kinds of text elements or other kinds of graphics that you end up using in your map or on a project. I want to draw your attention to this Identify tool right here as well. If I click the Identify tool and then I click on any particular item in my project, if I click on the United States, it will identify that particular geometry for me. Instead of having to select it and then go to the attribute table and looking for which one was selected, I can use the Identify button, click immediately on the geometry that interests me, and get this window that's based on all of the attribute information so I can see, okay, that's the United States, and all of the other information that was in the attribute table for me. Also, let me show you a few things about keeping organized. It's pretty common for shapefiles to have very strange names like this. This is country 04. I'm missing some letters here. This one, you can probably figure out what it is, especially when you look at this, but sometimes you do have shapefiles with some pretty strange names. And so I do want to point out to you that you can click over here and it will give you the option to rename this layer. It doesn't actually rename the shapefile. It's not doing anything to your data. But just for the purposes of looking over here at it in the table of contents, you know, I could rename it countries. And then I would have that. Then that would help me keep organized. So if you've got a whole bunch of things with strange names over here, you can go over there and change them just for the purposes of the project that you're working on.